Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and they show us their latest products and services. Today, I'm joined by Jason Miller. He is the Chief Evangelist and Principal Consultant for Creatio. Welcome to the show, Jason.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
All right. So what are you showing us today? You're showing, like, it's Creatio and you're showing us Creatio.
That is correct. So for those of you who are maybe not familiar with who Creatio is, we're a no-code application development platform. It's been around for about 10 years, and we've really focused on helping organizations have the maximum degree of freedom to automate any number of front office and back office processes. And we're going to talk about a little bit of that today and kind of showcase how the product does that in a number of ways.
And who's this designed for within a company? And is it also small companies, mid-sized companies, enterprises? Who's going to be using this mostly?
So really any organization of any kind of size. We target mid-level corporate and large enterprises. We've got some small SMB companies that use this as well, but really it's meant for mid-market and upscale.
Yeah. And what problems are you looking to solve here? Why should a viewer be interested in this versus some of the other platforms that are out there?
You know, there's really kind of three major areas that people find Creatio has a lot of value compared to, say, other technologies that are on the market. The first is speed and time to market. Using no-code technology, you have the ability to bring things to life and start recognizing value on your investment in a very short period of time. The second one is the fact that you're empowering citizen development, or we call them no-code creators, to work alongside your professional developers using no-code tools to help you rapidly develop new technology and new applications to deploy into the market. And then the third group is obviously the business, right? We know that there's not enough IT developers in the world, so empowering those folks, giving them the ability to manage the things that they should manage, and letting IT really focus on the important things like data governance, data security, and those types of things.
Yeah, and what would companies be doing if they did not have this application or this platform to use? Would they be would they be hiring a huge developer staff, or kind of trying to find more development time, or just longer processes, that kind of stuff?
Yeah, I mean, it's been a combination of everything. Yeah. Think about even where we went from 25 years ago when everybody was operating on a single mainframe, where we've really went over the last 15 to 20 years is to this commercial off-the-shelf model, right? Using SaaS-based tools to help move things quicker. That's why we went from waterfall to agile.
Yeah.
Well, with no-code tools, you're able to move even faster. So now you're able to not have to have massive IT groups. You're able to empower the citizen developers to work on things like front-end UIs, business processes, but not have to have this massive either army of developers on your internal bench or outsource to third parties to drive a lot of this development effort.
All right. I like the term massive army. That's what I was trying to think of. All right, so you're going to show a few key features of the platform. So let's jump right in and show us the demo.
Yeah, great. And what we're looking at now is kind of a typical user experience that you would see anywhere within Creatio. Now, keep in mind, Creatio is a no-code platform that you can build things on, or you can use any number of pre-built applications that are already on our platform. Matter of fact, what I'm going to show you today is kind of a CRM use case. We have built industry-leading CRM that covers any number of use cases. Now, as you can see, I'm a power user, so I have access to different workspaces.
Sure.
Now, the different users would have a limited view of this, right? Maybe it's somebody in sales or customer service or marketing. We're going to actually kind of focus on a service-based use case today because everybody out there has to service their customers in some way. Now, what's great is you can build great visuals across the platform, all again without using a single line of code. Everything I'm going to show you today has all been built without writing any code. This is all configuration. Now, one of the first things that organizations think about is understanding their customer. Call it that customer 360 degree view.
Right.
Well, I've brought up my favorite customer, Alex Wilson, here. And Alex is a great customer because he uses us for a lot of different things. So we're able to get all of that real-time engagement information, how we've interacted, where we've interacted, what sales engagements we've had with them. And you can see all of these things are readily available because we use an open architected type of solution to be able to connect to any number of data sets. Now, this could be something that's put internally within the CRM, or it could be something coming from an external system, like an ERP or a data lake or something like that. As we start to look into this, we can start to see that not only do we have the visibility, we can start to drill down into things. In this particular case, I've opened up a service request that this customer had, and you can see we do a lot of things like track and manage the engagements throughout this entire process. What's interesting is we can track all sorts of great information like closure and feedback and overall engagement. You'll also notice that we've got this kind of what we call a dynamic case manager or a progress bar here. Mm-hmm. What's really cool about this is we know that every business does business slightly different, but we all have the same general needs. So these types of things can be very easily configured. The user experience is, again, configured through drag and drop tools, literally selecting from hundreds of pieces in a pre-built library to create this type of user experience. And it's literally just drag and drop. Now, what's even more interesting, I talked about managing these businesses, and what we see here is kind of this case right here. You're able to drill into this and create all sorts of customized workflows and customized experiences. Maybe you want to engage multiple teams, you want to reroute things. This is easy to do. Now, again, we're looking at this through a service perspective, so customer service.
Right.
But you're also able to do this in any number of ways and build these flows for sales and marketing and maybe customer or customer journey and customer onboarding. What's so cool about this is each one of these has a configuration window that you see on the right side of the screen here. This is how we configure our way to success. And it's all sorts of different types of configurations that you can do. And there's these great different steps that are you know, kind of applied in this level. But one of the things I really wanted to point out is you can start driving automation with these sub-processes. And I've got a couple of great examples here, right? So this is, you know, maybe I want to notify somebody or I want to run a predictive and machine learning model and what data am I going to use it on? But what's really cool about this is I've got a pre-built library of hundreds of business processes that you can use as a template to configure to meet your own business needs without having to write them from scratch. And what's really cool about this is people start to understand what this looks like. And this is an example here. This is a BPMN standard process. If you've ever used Visio or Lucidchart or anything like that, it's the same nomenclature. But what's majorly different about this is actually executing things. I always like to point out the little gold diamonds on the screen.
Yeah.
That's a visual representation of an if-then statement. If yes, go right. If no, go left. Or any number of multivariable. And at each point in time, in each of these steps, you see we get, again, a configuration screen. This is what replaces custom code. The one other thing I wanted to showcase for you today here is not only does it do system interactions, it also does user interactions. This is the difference between, say, RPA and DPA. Yes, you can do all of your CRUD operations, but you also have the ability to do things like process files, interact with other systems, maybe enact a machine learning model, or run custom scripting. You can start daisy chaining processes together. This is really what gives that kind of unlimited freedom to automate any number of processes, whether it's front office, mid office, or back office, regardless of what type of organization you are.
Yeah, would most of the users that might not have been in an IT background, like they are in sales and marketing and they want to get started, would they most likely start with the templates and then kind of get comfortable with the system and then move into the other parts of the platform?
And that's a great question, and there's a ton of different ways you can do this. I'm going to show you an AI example of how to build something from scratch in a few minutes. But what's really cool is, yes, you literally have hundreds of templates for any number of use cases. Matter of fact, let me go call that up really quick. I'll hop over to our library of processes. And you can see we've already got hundreds of different folders. And each one of these folders, depending on what type of process you want to run, I just happen to be in the case folder right now. But you could be looking at this if you're in maybe sales, looking at lead processes or opportunity management. Or if you're looking at end-to-end process flow from a lead to cash process, it'll be different areas. But yes, you're gonna use these types of templates that all look very similar to this, and then you're able to start modifying that to align to your business instead of having to modify your business to align to the technology.
Right. Do you see that a lot in other platforms where you're forced into kind of a hole?
Yeah, and this is really one of the things that we like to talk about a lot when it comes up against, say, other CRM technologies especially. It's kind of that 80-20 rule. You end up having to run your business based on the 80% core configuration they've done, and then you spend millions of dollars kind of customizing around that core. This is what makes Creatio unique. If you think about like a normal CRM implementation, 12, 18 months, right? And that's on tech that's been around for 15, 20 years.
Yeah.
So people should know it. We find that the average implementation time for a Creatio CRM implementation is between 12 and 20 weeks, depending on how complex it is.
Yeah.
Because they're able to use these pre-built templates, because they're able to configure their way to success, you can get to an MVP in merely days and weeks.
All right, and so you want to show us the UI or the AI?
So the AI stuff. So what's even more interesting is this is an application hub, and this is where you manage kind of all of your applications and your composable elements that are part of this assembly that you've done. What's even cooler, though, is you have the ability to create new applications, and there's a bunch of different ways that you can create applications, right? You can maybe use a template, or you can use any number of apps from the marketplace, and this is just some examples. But one of the really fun ones, you can even use AI. And this is, think about it if you're in the kind of the world of low code, mm-hmm. right? A lot of professional developers will use natural language to create code. This is accomplishing the same thing. You have the ability to use natural language to define an application. This will give you a prototype in which you can then use the no-code tools to accelerate that time to get to MVP. Oftentimes, this is where organizations struggle the most, which is creating something from scratch. The other thing I like to point out a lot of times is using no-code tools, you're able to get to MVP much quicker, and that's because of just the simple fact you're able to modify as you go. Eliminating those long sprint cycles, mm-hmm. being able to prototype on the fly, being able to accelerate the time to fail, find out what is successful and what is not, and therefore iterating very quickly. A lot of times organizations are afraid to move forward. They're afraid to fail.
Yeah.
So they make sure that they go to the nth degree to document everything. That's what takes the discovery cycle 6 months or more. But what's extremely exciting is you can actually prototype on the fly using no-code tools and reduce that cost of failure and get to success much, much quicker.
All right, Jason, did you have anything else that you were going to show us?
I mean, there's a million different things in here. But, again, the thing to understand is that the no-code tool set allows individuals. Typically, this is like a BA profile, or maybe it's someone who comes from the business as a power user to work alongside those professional developers to achieve a lot of this. Because really, who knows the business processes better than someone who sits in the business? Now, what's really important to understand, too, is what makes Creatio unique compared to other tools on the market is Creatio is a fully governed application set when it comes to no-code citizen mm-hmm. development. We have the ability to deploy our governance application that sits on top of the platform to look at all the different environments and apply different levels of governance. This is typically the number one thing that organizations say that, hey, we're concerned about empowering citizen development. How do we govern this? And we've got the answer for
that. Just because you don't want those citizen developers to mess up, right?
Or do
something that they shouldn't be doing.
Exactly. And this is where, putting IT back in the driver's seat from a governance standpoint, putting IT back in the governance seat from a quality and control standpoint, right? Making sure that those role-based access controls are met, the GRC controls are met, any external governance controls you have. All of that's managed through our governance app. And what's even better about that is it helps unlock a lot of hidden potential that maybe doesn't get, to be used. How many times have we heard the term shadow IT and IT really backs away from that?
Yeah.
And what we're talking about here with Creatio is a fully governed set of no-code tools that can drive good citizen development practices.
And you've got a unique kind of a situation here. I usually ask about free trials and how people can try the platform. You do something a little different, don't you?
So we do, and yes, there are free trials that are available on our website, but really what we found to be most successful is just like when you first had Excel, you weren't an expert in how to code in Excel, right? You needed to learn that over time, and what we found is having guided trials, but really coming out to some of our events, we evangelize no-code all around the world. Yeah. Matter of fact, as we're recording this, we've got an event in Boston this week, we've got Chicago and New York and Santiago, Chile coming up. We just got back from Jakarta and Sydney and Warsaw, but we do these all around the world. And I encourage folks to come to creatio.com, learn about these events, and then come see us. We can give you customized demonstrations. Because it's so quick and easy to configure things, we can literally start to turn on what may be even a prototype for you in a matter of hours.
Right. All right, Jason Miller from Creatio, thanks for the demo.
Keith, appreciate it.
That's all the time we have for today's show. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.